so I just finished my third year in kind of a weird position where I'm teaching teachers, and it's very new for me. Little freshmen and sophomores in college, and experimenting with teaching and trying it out and making decisions. And one thing you really see is that when I talk to them about deficit modes of thinking and asset modes of thinking, they have no clue what I'm talking about. And it's really difficult to get our college freshmen to think about others. It's very difficult. So I came up, I heard this somewhere. I was talking to someone and they're like, oh, that's negatalk, stop it. I'm like, negatalk, what are you talking about? It kind of struck me and it stuck in the back of my head, but it connected with something I heard at, I don't know whether it was TMC or another conference, but when you hear something that is negative, when you hear something that is, actually I know exactly where I heard this, and it was TMC last year. When you hear something that is negative or offensive, step one is identify it, step two is name it, and step three is stop it. And I realized that for teachers, deficit thinking is a really serious issue that we have to stop when they're freshmen in college. So I attach some labels to the negative things. So when I hear my students say, oh, these kids can't solve an equation, I'm like, stop, that's negatalk. Stop the negatalk. And when I hear they can't, that's negatalk, stop. And the one that really sets me off is those kids. We all know the teachers saying those kids just burning my teeth around it. But then you have to have the positive talk as well. So I'm trying to turn every single instance of negatalk into a positive talk. So when I hear one of my students say, these kids can't solve it, guys are like, what's the positive talk complement to that? So turning every single statement that I hear from negatalk to positive talk. So then instead of saying they can't, they have to start saying, well, they can if we do this and this and this. And then I just look up and say, shut up, those are my kids too. You don't ever say those kids are up. So I've been percolating with this and really getting, trying to do this with my students, but then on Twitter, I saw this one page posted. And I'm gonna zoom in on it because this page just, it blew my mind because it gave me a really strong way to attack these ideas. I don't know what book it's from. I don't know where this is from. It was just that one page pictured and then posted on Twitter. But when a kid who has ADHD, the teacher is like, oh, they always lose things. Instead, here's the positive talk, unbounded by material things. Your kid talks too much. Instead, if you're like, that kid's very passionate and interested about ideas and things. Right? That, what a wonderful reframing from negatalk to positive talk. Or your child hates homework. And instead, if the teacher was thinking, oh, you know, your child has an incredible capacity for play. Well, that sounds interesting to me. Your child is obsessed with this one thing. Your child's very passionate about that one thing. Reframing from negatalk to positalk are mental perceptions. For my students, that's really powerful, but it also changes me, right? If I'm constantly alert for the negatalk in others, I start paying attention to the negatalk in myself. So I started just writing things down that I would see and observe. For example, I used to really say a lot in class when I was teaching high school, you know, Beth, you're very quiet today. What's wrong, right? So there's that negative assumption that something's wrong, but reframing that into, wow, you're really thoughtful today, Beth, I love it. When you're ready to share, please do. So it becomes an invitation, it becomes something positive. And it really fits nicely with what Alyssa was talking about, and I'm glad she said the two nice things today because this fits with that, except it's trying to head it off even earlier than not allowing that negative thing to be said at all. When you see it, identify it, maybe stop it. And the negatalk is something that we have to stop, that I have to stop with my pre-service teachers. So I posted on Twitter and several people chimed in about ELL students, and I love them, and so I wrote them down. But my list is really incomplete. So with pre-service teachers, I think we have to push this out. And with new teachers, we have to push this out. And with experienced teachers, we have to push this out. We have to stop the negative talk and start the positive talk. So I have that Google Doc is at this bit.ly. You can go in and just add more negative things. And for every negative thing you hear, if you don't have a positive thing, that's okay. But I'd really like to collect negative statements so that we can collectively think about what the positive statement is that we would want to say instead. And I have a list of world statements that I looked at every single day when I was teaching, and it was hung on my wall where only I could see it and my students couldn't see it, so that I would have immediate world statements. I want to have immediate positive statements too, but I want to share it out, that way everyone can.